Did Vijay sign up? Did Vijay
Lakshmi
sign up yet?
Yes, Lalita, I'm there.
Yes, she is.
Awesome,
there.
Awesome. Where are you, Vijay? I don't see you. Your beautiful face. Oh, there you go. Okay. Hi, everybody. Oh my God, we've got great attendance today also. 56 people already. Awesome, awesome. Hi, Golji. How are you? Great. So whenever we're ready, Geeta ji, tell me.
Yes, we are ready.
Awesome. Well, yes. Very good morning to all of you and a happy April month. Did you all get fooled for April 1st in a good sense, in good spirits? And that's the way we keep our spirits going. Today, our speaker is Vijay Lakshmi. And I have something very special to share about. We call her Viji with a lot of love and affection. Vijay is actually, she goes back almost 30 years from where I was her college mate in my bachelor's degree, where we were 9 women all together in one hostel room. And Vijay was one of the most sincere, most, I should say, most meticulous person who never failed to do her lessons. While we were all fooling around, Vijay always kept up with her lessons. So without much delay, I would like to introduce Vijay Lakshmi, who is a very popular dietitian today, who's got a master's degree or an MPhil degree. She is pursuing a PhD in nutrition and food science from Bharatiyar University. And this lady is actually even more powerful because she has not only dedicated her life to the to teaching nutrition to children, but she's also done a lot in hospitals, and she is from my hometown, Coimbatore. So Vijay's got some phenomenal experience in the field of nutrition and food science, and I'm very proud to have her on board today as one of our chosen speakers. Vijay has got some very interesting topic to share with you today about a balanced diet. How do you create a balanced diet? And that is what you're going to learn from her. And even better is that she is one amongst us in terms of the ethnicity. So she definitely would understand what it really means to have an Indian balanced diet, right? Without actually taking it beyond our roots, she's going to give us a lot of information on how we can eat a balanced diet by choosing many of the foods from our own descent. So without much delay, once again, I bring Vijay Lakshmi to the forum to do a great presentation today. Vijay, all the very best. It's lovely to hear you again after so many years. It gives me a lot of nostalgia. We were college mates and now we are sharing a professional ground together. Very happy for you. And let me tell you that the India home residents are all extremely inquisitive people, very powerful people. They love to learn and they keep, bombarding you with questions. So be ready for that and have a great session.
Thank you, Lalita. Thank you for your kind words. Good morning to all. I'm really blessed to have such a wonderful friend, Mrs. Lalita, and mentor Dr. Rao, and the audience of today's session. Today's our topic is balanced diet.
Vijay Lakshmi ji, you shared some different screen.
I think you just need to go to the other screen, Vijay. It says
other tab.
Yeah, the other tab.
Fourth, there. Yeah, presentation.
Yeah. So just click out of this and you'll go to the other tab there. It says 4th April presentation. Are you able to see it?
No, on top left. Screen.
Yeah. Left. Go to the left more.
Yes, click on it.
Are you able to see it, Vijay?
I'm able to see the slides, but
No, but I don't think you're sharing it. So why don't you stop sharing again? And then, yeah, now it's
yeah. Okay. Now, yes. Able to see?
Yes.
Now you're able to see? Okay.
Yes.
Thank you. One second.
Perfect.
Good morning, Paul. Today's the given topic is on balanced diet for seniors. So why we all eat every day from morning till night, but why do we need to discuss on balanced diet? A good diet is important for good health. According to reports by World Health Organization, a majority of the disease that older people suffer are a result of lack of proper diet. So why people don't eat properly in old age? Because of slow metabolism, loss of taste and appetite, improper digestion, health issues, low activity level, emotional reasons. So as we age, we face all these problems. Because of this, the people are not able to eat properly. Then add on to that undernutrition, underweight, overweight, obesity, again, obesity-related non-communicable diseases. So the non-communicable diseases are diabetes, heart disease, cancer, all this. Gastrointestinal changes in aging, decreased appetite, reduction in meals consumed. Now, we will see what is diet and balanced diet. What is diet? Diet is the sum of food consumed by the person. So we all know what is food. Food is what we eat, the food items, the substance we eat. The food can be healthy or unhealthy. But we all eat food, but whether we eat nutrients, food with good nutrients or healthy nutrients. A diet that contains all the vital nutrients required by the human body is called a balanced diet. So what is balanced diet? What we eat, the diet from morning till night should contain all required nutrients by our body. We all know what is food. Any substance that is eaten by people called food. The food is anything, idli or dosa, healthy food or unhealthy food, anything. Food contains nutrients. So what is balanced diet? Balanced diet is a diet which should contain all essential nutrients in right amounts required by the people. So the food contains nutrients. The nutrients are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, and water. Fiber, phytonutrients also comes under nutrient group. To achieve all these nutrients, the different nutrients, the requirement depending on the, are the requirements differs person to person, depending on their age or height, weight, their disease condition. To achieve these nutrients, if in case the people without any diseases, the healthy, normal person, to achieve all these nutrients, adequate amount of carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, fiber, the daily diet should contain the food groups in these amounts. It is shown in the picture. So the daily diet should contain cereals and millets as 240 grams. Cereals and millets, millets comes under this group. Then pulses and legumes. Meat and poultry all together 90 grams. Vegetables and green leafy vegetables 250 grams. Milk or curd or any other milk products around 300 ml. Nuts and oil seeds 30 grams. Visible fats and oils 27 grams. Visible fat and oils what we use, the cooking oil. Fruits 150 grams per day. Roots and tubers 100 grams per day. So to achieve the adequate amount of required nutrients, the daily diet should contain the food groups in this amount. we all should know this. So when we prepare a food, when we eat from morning till night, we have to see at the end of the day whether we have consumed all food groups in this amount. Sometimes we eat only cereals with vegetables chutney. We would have not used pulses. Sometimes we eat only vegetables or fruits. We miss one or two food groups from this. But we have to see whether our daily diet is met with all these food groups. Then only it is a balanced diet. I have shown one nutritious Indian meal plate. The plate should contain one cereal. The cereal can be with wheat or any other millet. Compared to rice, other millets like kambu, ragi, we call it as bajra, jowar, varagu, samai, tenai. So all Indian millets can be used as a cereal. And along with that, one or two vegetables should be present. Vegetables as poriyal or salad or kootu, and curd or buttermilk. So benefits of coming to benefits of healthy balanced diet. Why should we eat a balanced diet, or why should we know about balanced diet? This balanced diet, consuming balanced diet, helps to prevent certain serious diseases such as heart disease. As we age, we tend to have all these diseases, heart disease, stroke, type 2 diabetes, cancers. Eating a healthy diet may help you to recover quickly. Obesity and overweight. So to prevent from all these problems, or if in case a person has these diseases, to keep all these diseases under control, balanced diet is important. We saw the food contains nutrients, carbohydrates, proteins and fat, the vitamins, minerals and fiber. These three are called as macronutrients. The percentage of these nutrients in the daily diet is very important. So carbohydrate percentage should be 55% to 60%. This is to just to understand. Protein 15% and fat 25%. So when we eat our daily diet from morning till night, the carbohydrate, protein and fat from our diet should be within this percentage to prevent from all diseases or to control diseases. So how to achieve this percentage, or how to achieve adequate amount of vitamins, minerals and fiber? We have to fill our plate with carbohydrates, with complex carbohydrates, that is from cereals, the millet cereals and millets, small millets, and protein from pulses. So we have to fill our plate with pulses in adequate amount. Vegetables, green leafy vegetables and roots and tubers, all other vegetables can be taken. And fruits daily, milk daily, fat, healthy fat, cooking oil daily. We will see the different food groups and their nutrients in detail. So first food group, cereals, grains and its products. So rice, wheat, ragi, these are all the cereals what we eat daily or what we should eat. Compared to rice, we can include wheat, ragi, bajra, jowar, maize, or maize flakes, wheat flakes, rice flour, sprouted cereals, etc. These cereals contains carbohydrates, protein, insoluble fat, and B vitamins, folic acids, fiber. When we take rice or wheat or any other westernized processed food, it is with simple sugar, simple carbohydrates or refined carbohydrate. But when we exchange those items with these small millets, Indian traditional Indian based millets, it gives adequate amount of fiber, vitamins, minerals, complex carbohydrate. Yes, this is the advantage of consuming these cereals. Then we can make the food items from these cereals as dosa, idli, chapati, roti, upma, pongal, kichadi, all are traditional preparations. Next, coming to pulses and legumes, our daily diet should contain adequate amount of pulses and legumes, what we saw in the food group picture. the pulses and meat should all together 90 grams per day. So 50% can be for pulses and 50% can be non-veg for non-vegetarians, or lesser amount of non-vegetarians, more of pulses daily to meet the protein. Plant proteins are better tolerated or advantageous compared to animal proteins. Plant proteins are good in preventing heart disease, cancer, and other diseases. These pulses contains energy, protein, B vitamins, folic acid, calcium, iron, fiber. For example, if we take half gram, it is a good source of calcium. If in case we consume 50 grams of half gram or 25 grams of half gram, and 50% of our daily calcium requirement will be met, then all pulses are good source of iron. The pulses, whole pulses with the skin is a good source of fiber. So consuming pulses daily or including pulses daily in our daily in our diet is very important. Sometimes we include dal, or sometimes we take only sambar in a diluted form that would meet with all the required amount of protein or other nutrients from pulses. So we have to concentrate on the required amount should be met with our daily diet. Next group is milk and milk products. The required amount is 300 ml per day. This 300 ml can be for old age, for seniors, the 300 ml of milk can be fat-free milk or with low-fat milk, or if it is with fat milk, we have to remove the cream from that. The milk is a source of fat, proteins, minerals, water, carbohydrates, and B vitamins. Milk, compared to milk, curd is good because it is a fermented product. It is good for the digestive tract. Next, coming to the high protein source, non-vegetarian. If the person is a non-vegetarian, instead of one serving, 25 grams of pulse, 75 to 100 grams of non-veg can be taken, any non-veg, chicken or mutton or egg, one egg, fish, 100 to 150 grams. Fish is a better non-veg source than other non-vegetarian food. Fish, why fish is good? Fish is a source of omega-3 fatty acid. It is a good source of fat, but if we take egg and other non-veg, it is the fat source is saturated fat, more of saturated fat. So we can restrict to other non-vegetarian foods and replace with fish. Next group is vegetables. Vegetables are grouped as green leafy vegetables and other vegetables, roots and tubers. So green leafy vegetables and other vegetables altogether can be taken as 250 grams, because per day requirement is around 500 grams fruits and vegetables together. 250 grams of vegetables can be included. Green leafy vegetables are low calorie, so no restriction. Other vegetables also can be taken without any restriction. The two different colored vegetables should be included in our daily diet. Green color, orange color, pink or red, purple color, because different color has different nutrients, especially phytochemicals. It has advantage in preventing the diseases. So when we eat vegetables, or when we purchase vegetables, when we cook vegetables, we have to see whether we are including adequate amount of vegetables in a daily diet. That too, different from different groups and different color vegetables. Next group is roots and tubers. Roots and tubers, carrots, beetroots, and other tubers, potato, yam, colocasia. These are taken as 100 grams per day. Next is a fruit group. 1 to 2 fruits daily should be consumed, at least around 100 grams per day, maximum 300 grams. All these kind of vegetables, if the person is diabetic, only these kind of vegetables fruits can be taken. If in case the patient is not a diabetic, a person is not a diabetic, all vegetables can be taken around 100 grams per day. When we select fruits also, we have to see the type of fruit or color of the fruit, quantity of the fruit. Because if we take papaya, papaya has vitamin C. If we consume 100 grams of papaya, our daily requirement of vitamin C is met. If we consume one guava daily, three times of our vitamin C is requirement is met. Vitamin C is a good antioxidant preventing all diseases or controlling diseases. Watermelon is a good source of iron and phytonutrients. Fruits should be consumed daily. Fruit as such can be taken instead of fruit juice, because fruit juice is a simpler form of sugar. It gets digested faster and sugar level is increased. So better to consume as a fruit, then we can achieve the fiber also. Next group is fats and sugars. Sugars, as per WHO recommendation, sugar is only 10 grams, 10 to 20 grams per day, that is around 4 teaspoons. 1 teaspoon is around 5 ml spoons, 4 teaspoons per day. So when we use sugars daily, we have to see how many teaspoons we use daily. Because when we take tea, coffee or juice or any other drinks with sugar, without realizing, we consuming more of sugars, 50 grams, sometimes up to 100 grams also. So we have to stick with this 10 to 20 grams of sugar, 2 to 14 teaspoons of sugar per day. If the person is diabetic, then sugar should be avoided completely. Instead of sugar, this brown sugar jaggery can be used. Next, fats. Cooking oil is the best source of fat, good fat. It contains all essential fatty acids. This fat or oil contains different fatty acids. We all know the fatty acids are saturated fats, polyunsaturated fats, and monounsaturated fats. Monounsaturated fats are good fats. Next to monounsaturated fat, polyunsaturated fat, and the saturated fat should be less in our daily diet. So when we use cooking oils, that to groundnut oil, mustard oil, gingerly oil, rice bran oil is a good source of all three fatty acids. So if we use these kind of oils, all fatty acids are met in right proportion. These are all recommended oils for cooking. Butter, ghee, okay. If we want to take ghee, instead of this oil, quarter teaspoon or half teaspoon, ghee can be used. Butter and hydrogenated oils are a source of saturated fat. So better, butter itself can be restricted, but better to avoid hydrogenated oils because it is a source of trans fat also. Trans fat is not at all good fat. It increases LDL, bad cholesterol in the blood. So this fat gives energy, fat, essential fatty acids, etc. But when we choose the fat, we have to choose the good fat. Next, omega-3 fatty acids. So this is also a type of fatty acid present in oils or nuts and seeds. This is a good fat. This can prevent heart disease or control heart disease, prevents cancer, and it is good for controlling other diseases also. So source of omega-3 fatty acids, best source of fish. For vegetarians, vegetable oils, nuts, flax seeds is a good source of omega-3 fatty acid, flaxseed oil and leafy vegetables. This flax seeds can be used in our daily diet. Around 25 grams of flax seeds can be used to meet this omega-3 fatty acids. Walnuts can be used. Walnuts, all almonds and walnuts together, 10 to 20 numbers can be used. Chia seeds, flaxseed oils, soya beans also can be used. Soya bean oil also can be used. These are all omega source of omega-3 fatty acid. So far, we saw the food groups we use daily in our daily diet. Next, coming to salt. Salt is very important. WHO recommends only 5 grams of salt per day. But when we cook food items from morning till night, we use more salt than this recommended amount. Usually, even if we prepare the items with less salt, the salt will come up to 8 grams per day. If in case we use normal salt and take normal quantity of food, 10 grams salt. If we use other salty foods, pickles, vatal, chips, vada, then the salt is more than that. But the recommended amount is only 5 grams. So when we prepare the food items, when we use the salt, we have to be very conscious about the salt. Keeping salt intake to less than 5 grams per day prevents or controls hypertension and heart diseases, stroke, etc. High consumption of sodium leads to high blood pressure and increase the risk of heart disease and stroke. So already we are consuming excess amount of salt. So we have to concentrate on salt intake. If in case the person is with blood pressure or cardiac problem or diabetes, definitely the salt intake should be reduced. Now coming to the food items we eat. So far we have seen the food groups taken daily. The food groups should be converted into food items to consume. Breakfast is very important. The time of breakfast is also very important. We should not miss breakfast. The advantage of taking breakfast and on time, some people miss breakfast. So breakfast should be consumed. The advantage is it reduces hunger throughout the day. Sometimes the people miss breakfast, then later on consume more of snacks. So it reduces hunger throughout the day. Overeating and poor food choices of meals. Cognitive development. Breakfast is important for cognitive development. Nutrient adequacy. So when we consume all three meals in right amounts, the nutrient required nutrients will be met. Then taking breakfast control the weight. How the breakfast should be? The breakfast should be with cereal, pulse, and vegetables. So far we saw all food groups, cereals, pulses, milk and milk products, oil, sugar, fruits, vegetables. So all three meals should be with one cereal, pulse, and vegetables. Next to lunch. Lunch, this is South Indian meal shown on the plant leaf. Rice, one cereal with two, three vegetables. Okay. Or tiffin box. And even we can be any part of India, but the basic principle is each meal should contain one cereal, each meal should contain pulse, each meal should contain vegetable. With this, we can prepare depending on our culture. For example, if the person is a South Indian, then idli sambar, chutney with sambar with vegetables. So cereal, pulse, and vegetable is added, all three met. But the pulse also should be in right quantity, not watery sambar. If the person is a North Indian, Gujarati, or Punjabi, then the basic principle is this, the basic food groups, depending on their food habits, their breakfast, lunch, and dinner consumption, they can prepare the food items, what they eat. But all three meals should be with cereal, pulse, and vegetables. Again, dinner, the different items can be prepared from the basic food groups, cereal plus pulse and vegetable combination. Early morning milk can be taken, curd can be taken with lunch, evening milk or any snacks with cereal and pulse combination. Then night, if the person has the habit of drinking milk, night also can be taken, but around 300 ml per day altogether. Early dinner can burn more fat. Sometimes the people eat, this COVID time in India, most of the people eat late dinner around 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock. Sometimes this IT people eat, take late dinner. So early dinner can burn more fat, prevent from other diseases also. So the dinner time is also important. snacks, in between snacks can be healthy snacks. Instead of taking this bakery items, biscuits, other bakery items, biscuits only refined flour. So any bakery items with the refined flour, simple carbohydrate, can be replaced with these kind of traditional snacks prepared from the natural food items. If the person is a diabetic, then without sugar can be taken. These kind of snacks also can be taken. If the person is a diabetic, salads, cucumber, carrot salads, or other vegetables also can be included. Nuts can be taken. This roasted pulse can be taken. Corn is a good source of fiber. It is a good snack to take in between. Groundnuts can be taken. Groundnuts only 15 grams weekly, twice or thrice. Vegetable salads, fruit salads, egg, or any other preparation with egg. Then these kind of snacks also can be taken. Ragi seva, rice seva, aval upma. There's a chapati stuffed with vegetables. Then when we prepare the food item, we should not forget to use the spices. Spices has medicinal value. Onions, garlic. Onions has a post hypoglycemic effect. So along with breakfast onion chutney, or onions can be included with dosa, uttapam, like that. It has a sugar controlling effect. This garlic, the 2 pods can be taken daily. That is the allowance which prevents heart disease or controls or lowers the cholesterol level. Ginger also, one small piece daily can be taken or should be taken. This pepper, cumin seeds, other pulses, cinnamon. One small piece of cinnamon can be, if taken daily, it controls blood sugar or it reduces blood sugar. Cloves can be taken. This fenugreek, 15 grams should be used daily. It has a sugar lowering effect. Fenugreek should be used daily. It's got good fiber also. Then turmeric, 1/4 teaspoon of daily should be, turmeric should be used daily in our diet. Asafoetida also can be used. So these are the spices should be used daily. We have to prepare the food items at home based on our traditional eating habits. Then only all these spices will be met. If in case only the bread is taken, in between 10 o'clock biscuits eaten, afternoon only chapati with some salads taken, this spices will not be met. So we have to prepare at least 1 or 2 meals should be prepared with using these spices. Using 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric prevents from cancer. Even from early age can be used. It prevents cancer. Next, coming to coffee, tea, 1 coffee and 1 tea can be used daily, not more than that. Compared to coffee, tea is good. That too, instant coffee should not be taken. Filter coffee can be used with less chicory. Instead of this, this tea or black tea also with a good amount of antioxidants. In between, if in case we want to drink tea or any other hot like water, we can use this dipped tea. There are different flavors available on the market. Those teas also can be taken. Hibiscus tea is good for controlling the blood sugar and blood cholesterol level. And there is called chamomile tea that also can be used. Unhealthy foods. So we call all items as a food. These are all also food, but these are all unhealthy food. Why these are called unhealthy? This is high in energy, low in protein. So far we saw the different food groups, the amount required and nutrients present in food items and how it can be prepared. All 3 meals and in between snacks should be with natural food items. All food groups should be present. These are all processed foods with refined carbohydrate, not complex carbohydrate. These are all with high sodium, high sugar, low in vitamins and minerals, low in fiber. When we take the natural food items, natural food groups, it is the cereals, whole cereals or other millets or high in fiber. Vegetables and fruits are high in fiber. Pulses, whole pulses are high in fiber. If in case we replace the one meal with these items or in between snacks with these item, we will not be able to meet with adequate amount of our required nutrients. So these are all high in unsaturated fat and trans fat. So when the foods are processed, trans fat is produced. Trans fat is the culprit for cardiovascular disease. If in case we want to have ice cream compared to softy, hardy ice cream can be taken. Hardy is with a good nutrients than that. Then these type of high fatty meals should not be avoided. Anyway, old age cannot eat like this. When we purchase food items, any food with labels, packaged foods, we have to learn to read the labels, the energy content of that food item, protein, fat, the amount of sugar present in that, type of fat present in that, saturated fat, how many grams, monounsaturated fat, polyunsaturated fat, trans fat, cholesterol, carbohydrates and sugars, and the ingredients used in that product. The label says it is palm oil. Palm oil is a saturated fat. It is not good. And physical activity is important. Shall we go for the discussion?
Yeah, sure. You want to stop the screen share or is it okay? Anything is fine. Yeah, anybody, if you have any questions or any discussion, you can unmute yourselves.
Yeah, I have a question. Vijayalakshmi, thank you very much. This is Kishan from New York. And yes, thank you very much sharing your experience and educating us all the way from India. Appreciate it very much with your knowledge and expertise and everything. Myself and most of us, you know, we are senior citizens. Most of us, if not all of us, are vegetarian, eat healthy food. But like Lalita said, most of you are doctors and scientists. They bombardment us with all numbers and percentage and grams. And if we sit down here calculating in dinner time each and everything and waving it, our dinner time will be over and we'll go crazy. Basically, we eat basic pulses and vegetables and fruit. Is it okay? How do we calculate? How do we figure it out?
Sir, no need to calculate. No need to calculate. Just for to understand these are all available sources. To understand about the percentage of nutrients we require, I showed that slide. No need to sit and calculate, sir, because each person requires the calories. The nutrients, we require the nutrients, energy, protein, fat, vitamins, minerals. If you take vitamins, there are so many vitamins, minerals. We don't need to sit and calculate. Okay, these are all nutrients required. So energy, okay, require one amount of energy, 1600 calories, 1500, 1800, 2000, depending on the person, it differs. Okay, so these are all the nutrients required. This is for understanding. Okay, sir, these nutrients are present in the food items what we eat daily. Okay, so our daily diet should be with natural food items. That's
okay. Okay, thank you.
The food groups, cereals, our daily diet should contain cereals, pulses, milk and milk products, fats and sugars, meat and meat products. If a person is vegetarian, no need to bother about the meat. And fruits and vegetables. This we have to definitely see. You don't have to sit and calculate, but we have to see whether we eat all food groups daily. Okay?
Okay, thank you, Ramesh. Basically, what you are suggesting is go nominal and not to overeat or no overdoing everything.
Yes, sir. So different food groups we have to see. And I had one slide on the quantity of food items. Quantity of food items, definitely we should remember for each person. Okay. This carbohydrate percentage and protein percentage, we don't have to calculate. This is for the understanding.
Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you very much.
You have
thank
to, you. But you have to see at the end of the day, you have to see whether I have taken fruit today, 1 to 2 fruits daily. This you have to remember. 1 to 2 fruits daily, around 500 grams of vegetables daily, oil only 3 to 4 teaspoons daily. Okay, sir. Sugars only 2 teaspoons daily. Pulses, you don't have to see the quantity, but when we purchase pulse, we know quarter kg is how much, half kg is how much. So your consumption should be around 50 grams daily, we know how much would be this 50 grams. When we use for cooking also, we know. So with the conscious, we have to cook. So we have to see whether we have taken adequate pulse today. Cereals also.
But because of the age and stage, we try to take care of our body and diet and everything. But sometimes, once in a while, if we go in blue moon to parties or something, then, you know, yes, we carry over on it.
This is our daily diet. Okay, sir, taking from natural foods, daily diet. This is basic principles to be followed, definitely.
Right.
While if you go out, you have to choose the healthy food item from the menu available.
Okay.
The food items available. Definitely, there are so many food items will be available if you go for buffet style. Or when you order and take it, definitely you cannot order anything. For example, I showed the ice cream slide. Instead of going for softy ice cream, you can go for hardy ice cream. That too, one full scoop or one full cup, you can restrict the quantity when you take. Or with the ice cream, you can add fruits. If in case you are a diabetic, you can add the fruits allowed for a diabetic. You can avoid other fruits. These things you have to follow, sir.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you.
Okay, Kiranji, do you have any questions?
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm going to ask about the sugars. You know, there are natural sugars when we pick up like dates or some fruits. So how do we balance with that? You said 2 teaspoons, just these white sugar, right? That's what you said, ma'am. Right? And if we are not diabetic. And then with the natural sugars, how do we do it? Like with the fruits or with the dates or with those figs? How do we balance?
Yes, you can take, ma'am, as you said, the fruits, but that also should be in restricted amount. Anyway, it is sugar. It is with the sugar and it is a simpler form. So you have to restrict the quantity. Instead of white sugar, definitely this is good because dates or figs, any other fruits, it is really good source. There are so many other essential nutrients present in that, but it is high in sugar. So you have to restrict the quantity.
Okay. Can you substitute with gur?
Pardon, sir?
Yeah. Can you substitute sugar with a gur?
Jaggery, yeah, that's right.
Jaggery.
In white sugar, jaggery is good. But jaggery also, with restriction only, the same amount, but it is good. Compared to white sugar, jaggery is good, but the amount is same.
So everything should be limited.
Yeah.
Everything we have to eat less.
Yes.
Yes.
Modern control discipline. This is with the sucrose, that is with little high amount of fructose. Anyway, it is sugar. If you consume more amount of fructose, it will lead to, if you consume more amount of glucose and fructose, it will lead to diabetes. If you consume more amount of fructose, it will lead to fatty liver.
Yeah, Mangalaji has some question. Yes, Mangalaji, go ahead. Mangala-san.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Vijayalakshmiji, for your information. Most of the Indians, no matter where they are, they say that if they are original Indian, no matter where they settle, they have diabetic or pre-diabetic. That is the survey now says. So my question is,
okay, bol.
Whatever we eat, sugar is there. So now they're saying that there is no need. Can you hear me? I didn't see you.
Yes, we can hear you.
Now yes, ma'am. They say that because whatever we eat, everything includes sugar. So there is no need of putting this white sugar. White sugar is like in Ayurvedic, they say it is jahar, it's a poison. So now my question is it true that we should stop that white sugar totally? Even the normal person.
Yes, ma'am. If the white sugar is not at all required, actually, we used to take the items with sugar. That is why we are consuming sugar. But no nutritional value or benefit by taking white sugar. If the person is not used to white sugar, completely stop, it is good. For children, when we teach children, when they start weaning food for the babies, we tell them that not introduce sugars. So they will not get used to that taste. It is better
not to eat. The another question is, now they say that at least we should eat 4 to 5 fruits every day. That is a requirement. Any thought on that?
4 to 5 fruits altogether, vegetables and fruits together, around 500 grams or 600 grams. At this COVID time, the WHO has recommended up to 900 grams to meet all the immunonutrients. But not only fruits, 4 to 5, ma'am. Fruits can be restricted, 1 to 2. If in case any one day, if you eat more amount, no problem. That 1 to 2 means 200 grams per day.
I see. And the, yes, about ma'am. The tea, they say that tea has a cancerous element there if we drink that one.
No.
No. Oh, I see. And the another thing, the cow's milk, right? Here, the milk is not, the cow was fed with the corn and all this starch and this and that. So it has already sugar too much in cow's milk. So what do you think? What do you suggest on that?
Ma'am, instead of cow's milk, can go for this packaged low-fat milk or fat-free milk. Or soya milk is a good option. Soya milk is really good. Soya natural, plain soya milk is available, which can be used for tea, coffee, drinking milk as such, for making curd.
Thanks.
It is good for this controlling diabetes, heart disease, lowering the LDL cholesterol. But milk doesn't have that advantage. It has saturated fat.
Thank you.
Yes. Anyone else? Please unmute yourself. If you have any questions, please unmute yourself so that.
Is it good brown sugar?
Josnan.
Yeah, I have question that instead of white sugar, I use brown sugar. Is it good or white sugar I have to use?
Brown sugar is good.
Brown sugar is good, right?
Good. Yes.
And which salt I have to use? Iodized, sometimes I have high BP. And I use Sindalum too. You know, Ekadasi, we use Sindalmita salt. Maybe you know or don't know.
This plain salt, iodized salt can be used, ma'am. Any other salt, it is from natural source, then that salt itself will have iodine. Can be used.
Okay. Yeah, must be. And instead of sugar, I use in vegetables sometimes jaggery. Then what is good, sugar or jaggery?
Jaggery, ma'am.
Jaggery is good, right? And one more question I have. I'm vegetarian, only I eat eggs. But my son and daughter-in-law, sometimes they eat chicken, fish, not every fish, all fish, but I believe that after long time, it's in old age, it is no good for hot temperature or I believe that way, that if eat chicken or more fish, non-veg, any food, then I believe that it's make hot temperature. Is it good or not? Am I right or not?
You're right, ma'am. Non-vegetarian allowance itself weekly twice, around 100 grams per...
What? Go ahead.
Chicken is allowed weekly once or twice, ma'am. Around 100 grams per day. So that will not harm your body.
Not harmful. Yeah.
Yes. And compared what about fish? Compared to mutton is good quality meat. Mutton also...
Yeah. You know, my son always bought... buy a good chicken value. I mean, not he eat white chicken, white part, not okay. Red meat he doesn't eat, like a beef or he's very good, concentrated in food buy. Yeah.
Red meat is not good, ma'am. White meat.
Yeah, I know.
Mutton can be taken. Then compared to mutton and chicken, fish is good.
Oh, fish is good.
Fish is very good.
But when we but fry not the... all fish good, right?
All fish.
Salmon.
Salmon, tuna, sardines are very good. These are good omega-3, source of omega-3 fatty acid.
Uh-huh.
Very good. 100 to 150 grams per week.
Oh, per week.
Per week. 100 to 150 grams twice per week.
Twice.
The quantity is very important, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Vijay Lakshmiji.
Yes, mother.
I wanted to ask. Geeta ji, I wanted to ask a question. Is it okay?
Yes, please.
I have a digestion. My digestion is always very bad. So I don't now eat chilies. I mean, other spices, yes, we put, but the chilies I don't put. But then every day, a banana agrees with me. So I do take one banana daily, definitely. Sometimes I take even two if I'm feeling like I want to have something more, like
digestion
and yogurt and milk agrees
with
me.
Digestion means what problem you face, ma'am?
I get a lot of acidity and gas.
Acidity and gas.
Yes.
For acidity and gas, you have to reduce the chilies. Anyway, chili powder, masala powders.
Yeah. That is already less.
Coffee is not good. Then eating on time is important.
Yeah.
And then banana is good, actually.
Banana is good. Not this... fruits like orange, lemon, the sour fruits, oranges, lemons, pineapple, grapes, fruits should be avoided.
Okay, so they have that acidic thing.
Yes, puli, tamarind rasam, the food items prepared with the tamarind, these things avoided for some time. And timing, frequent meals important.
I think, although I take omeprazole morning and evening, but still after food, sometimes I get a lot of gas also.
What time you eat your breakfast or lunch, ma'am?
Morning mostly I take a banana or maybe one biscuit or so, something with it.
Oh, okay.
That's my breakfast.
It's not adequate.
No.
Can avoid
because lentils give me more gas. Especially
do is you soak the lentils, then prepare.
Okay. All right.
Lentils, then prepare. When you take lentils, introduce it with less quantity, not much at a time.
No, I take very less, but yes. But I prefer daytime, not nighttime. Yeah.
I think a breakfast should be with one cereal, not biscuit is not a cereal.
That's once in a while I take. I take mostly banana. That's
your all. Breakfast should be early breakfast around 7:30 and one cereal. A soft item with like a pongal or khichdi like that.
Yeah, okay.
That little pulse and a little with less spicy, with little vegetable. So you have to change your food item like that. If you eat one,
I think I love
banana alone for breakfast, that is not sufficient.
Okay, thank you.
It takes time for digestion. That itself will increase the acidity.
Yeah. I've got my endoscopy and colonoscopy done, everything. It's okay but I think my stomach doesn't take certain things, you know. Right?
If you change your food habits, the timings.
I think timings is one thing, maybe.
Main meal and in between main meal and next to main meal, breakfast and lunch, dinner, the gap 4.5 hours. Main meal and in between snack, in between meal should be in 2.5 hours gap.
Okay, thank you.
That frequency is important. Then adequate sleep is important. Sleeping on time is important.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, that is important.
If you change all these basic things, then it will get corrected.
Thank you.
Appointment a week ma jurish ke?
Na next week ma.
Okay. Who wants to go next?
How about the tea? You said only one cup a day. That won't.
Better to. How many cups you want to drink, ma'am?
At least 3 cups.
no 3 cups. Only 1 cup.
Oh.
Instead of that, you introduce having soup. Or vegetable juice, vegetable soup, like that. If you want
hot. So even the dip tea is not good, like, you know, that.
Dip tea can be taken.
Okay, that's what I take.
If you reduce the quantity, you can take tea, ma'am. But if you continuously take tea, then other items you will not be able to consume. You will not meet with your required nutrients. Instead of one tea, if you take one vegetable juice or vegetable soup, you will meet with fiber, vitamins, minerals, good nutrients.
Okay, thank you. I'll try. Yes,
Ratna Kumar, do you want to go? Ratna Kumar.
Yes. Can I green tea, madam, 2 times?
Green tea 2 times can be taken.
It's good.
It's good.
Sometimes I want to drink
green tea maximum 300 ml, not more than that.
3 cups is good?
Maximum 300
ml. Oh, okay.
Good. We can go maximum up to 300 ml. Because some people, because it is good, from morning till night, throughout the day, they keep on drinking green tea. That is not...
That's my bad habit. Yeah, that's green why my gas problem going up.
No, it has adverse effects also. Maximum 250 to 300 ml green tea.
Oh, thank you. Okay. I have gastric problem tomorrow.
Gastric problem for anyone has gastric problem. You have to change your sleeping time and you have to change your eating time. Early breakfast, early lunch, early dinner. Then in between main meals, some snacks, less spicy. Then if you change these basic things, acidity will come down.
I am also taking omeprazole 40 mg every day, long time.
Yeah, early morning, if you take this millet-based any preparation, your acidity will come down. There's a white pumpkin. Is it available? Do you have the habit of taking that white pumpkin?
Yeah, yes.
We call it as pusnika.
Uh-huh.
Pumpkin. If you have white pumpkin juice early morning, it is good for reducing your acidity. In 1 week, if you drink continuously for 1 week, your acidity will come down.
Not yellow pumpkin? White
not pumpkin yellow pumpkin, white different. Pumpkin.
Is different? Oh.
Yellow pumpkin is different, white is different.
You mean dudi?
In Tamil, we say yellow pumpkin is arasanika, white pumpkin is pusnika. We use it for this drishti, no? That is white pumpkin.
In the stores, so far we available, in the stores are available, white
yes,
pumpkin.
Yes, you will be able to get it.
It is available.
Available.
White pumpkin
I don't
is available,
know, ma'am,
it is not dudi. Dudi is not white pumpkin.
It is not dudi. Yeah, it is called white gourd, or there is another name to it. I can actually send you the name, but it is green on the outside and it is almost oval or round, and it's big like a it's almost big like a watermelon, and it's got yellow seeds inside, and it's completely white inside. It's white pumpkin, and it's not dudi. Dudi is almost pale.
Kodu. Kind of.
No. Let me tell you exactly what the name, the English name is. But I can, like Vijayalakshmi was saying, a lot of what she has given you as information today is only information for you to be aware of what all is included in the food. To be very precise on the quantities and the amounts, each person has got an individual diet based on their GI sensitivity, based on their eating patterns, based on their other comorbid conditions like diabetes, blood pressure, blood sugar, all of those. So her guidelines were more for what is it to be having a balanced diet. As far as some of the extremes that she mentioned, I think that is always addressed to everybody. But as specifics are concerned, for example, if you are supposed to be low in calcium, maybe you can take more milk. So these specifics, that's where you need to probably consult individually with one of the dietitians and clear that out. But to avoid the omeprazole and to avoid the acidity in your body, early meals, avoiding too many gaps between your meals, avoiding spicy food, avoiding very heavy meals, especially in the nighttime, and also sleeping at a very good regular pattern. Sleepless nights can also lead to acidity in the mornings.
So the pumpkin should be raw when we make a juice, or it has to be cooked?
Raw. Anything, ma'am. You can make juice. This white one is pumpkin.
Oh.
Okay.
Anything. You can just make it with raw, or you can just put it in boiled water and you can make juice.
Thank you.
Then we call, have this karunjeeraham. I don't know what to say.
Kala jeera.
Karunjeeraham. It is called as perunjeeraham also. The name in English.
It is
kala, for,
kala jeera. You can show them a picture, Viji.
You put the jeera in the juice?
Cumin seeds, right? Cumin seeds.
Can put in the juice or early morning, you buy that one, make a powder, add powder into hot, warm water and take it early morning.
Kala jeera powder. Thank you.
Yeah, can you show us a kala jeera? Because there is one very thin one, which is called jeeri.
This is how it looks.
Yes, exactly, Lalita.
This is kala jeera for you guys.
I can't see the picture, actually.
I didn't see the picture.
This is actually very good for Lalita, acidity.
Lalita, I didn't see the picture.
It is good for acidity. It is only pinch should be taken. Up to 2 months can be taken. After that, you can stop.
Thank you.
Comes down, you can stop.
You can just soak this in water and have this every day in the morning, first thing.
Kala jeera, I didn't see, Lalita ji.
This is jeera, no? Normal jeera you're talking about.
Yes.
Right? It's not kala normal jeera. It is little different.
It's like lavang, but it is more like a long, lengthy thing.
Okay.
It will be in... big size and black color.
You'll get it in all Indian stores, so Patel Brothers.
Yes, it is available. It is available.
Also,
they have it. Their Patel store have it.
Yes, also sabja seeds put in water, okay. About half a teaspoon or quarter teaspoon is also a very good acidity coolant.
Yes.
Yes. Sabja also, I heard someone tell
you. I think Pratibha ji has been waiting to ask a question for the longest time.
Chia seeds also good. Chia seeds also good.
No problem. Sorry, I think I butted it.
Go ahead. Yeah.
I have a question. What food is good for the arthritis? Arthritis. I have a very bad arthritis. So what is good?
Rheumatoid arthritis, ma'am?
Yeah.
Rheumatoid, taking balanced diet, your diet should be with only natural foods. First thing, your diet should be with only natural foods in adequate amounts.
Just spice important. Spices. Indian spice is good.
Spices. Spices can be used. Can be used. Then pulses should be in correct amount, not more than the requirement, pulses. Then when you take non-vegetarian egg, if in case you feel pain after taking that, you have to avoid that. Any food item, if you feel pain after taking that food item, that particular food item should be avoided.
Besides that, Pratibha,
if you are not a diabetic, using carrots, very good.
Also, Pratibha,
omega-3 fatty acid sources. Source of omega-3 fatty acid foods can be included. Omega-3 fatty acid is very good.
Okay. Also, anti-inflammatory inflammatory foods. So basically, yes. Capsicum or any of the other foods that has got anti-inflammatory properties. So the arthritis mainly swells between your knuckles and between your joints. And that's when you have pain, it becomes severe. So anything, as Viji was saying, the omega-3 fatty acids, for example, salmon or your fatty fishes, walnuts, flax seeds, chia seeds, these may all have omega-3. Other than that, you can also include a lot of the anti-inflammatory vegetables like capsicum, garlic. All of these have a good property of anti-inflammatory. Turmeric is also very good for anti-inflammatory properties.
Sorry, my battery was down. So no.
That's okay. That's okay. Itaji, how are we thinking?
Yes, time? I know, like, we are running out of time. Like, we'll take last one question, Rita Koliji. This is your last question. Then we are going to wind
Thank
up.
You.
Yes, Rita ji, unmute yourself. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Very informative session. And
very informative. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. My question, I have to ask you a question.
Yes,
the question is the chia seed. How we consume chia seeds?
That's my question. Thanks.
Chia seeds, you can soak it with 1 teaspoon. Up to 1 teaspoon can be used. Can be soaked in water or in buttermilk.
No, I mean, you don't use in food or something where you mix it and you, and it is, they swell. They become like a, you know, beads, big beads. But you just eat it as with the spoon as it is, or it has to be, you know, I mean to say that any seed you can put it in the water and eat it, but what is the use? What is the proper way of using it?
No, only this is chia seeds and sabja seeds better to be put it in the water and consume it. I think the availability will be better. Yes, Lalita.
Chia seeds can also be used in a lot of baking products, because when you put it in there, it also kind of swells up with anything that has got a liquid batter and stuff. It can also be used in salads where there is a little bit of liquid. But eating chia seeds as is raw, it can cause a little of irritation in your stomach because it's got a lot of fiber in it too. So definitely a good recommendation is to soak it in water So it kind of lightens up a little bit, because it those little feather-like things that you see in the chia seeds, those are the ones that help it get digested a little bit more easier. So you want to either put it in your breads to cook it up, or put it in your salads where it's got a little bit of extra moisture. Just keep it in there, but do not just put it as a raw form or put it in your mouth and chew it down. It may not be the best to do.
Okay. But you can drink water. You can drink the water which you soak it in.
Absolutely. You can do that. Yes.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Thank you. I'll send a recipe for next our recipe. I'll send it chia seeds. Okay. Don't worry.
Thank you. That's great.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot.
Once again, thank you for the organizers for giving this opportunity. And
Thank you.
Thank you for the audience also. I really
thank you very much.
Yeah, we really